Do you think your defense has set the tone the way it did tonight, Coach?
Well, we knew that, like I told Tim before the game, that we both played the same kind of defensive schemes, and whoever got the takeaways was probably going to win the game. They've kind of had that year or two where they took the football away a lot on defense. We've done the same. And you know, it's not rocket science. If you take care of the ball and you get a lot of takeaways, you increase your chances of winning. We did.
Talk about Marcus, son. He did a lot of taking away, it seemed like.
Marcus is a special player. His best football is ahead of him. And I was really excited on the national stage for him to have that kind of game.
Coach, you played Fresno, you coached against Fresno many times when you were here in Hawaii. Is there something a little extra special you get whenever you get a chance to beat the Bulldogs?
Well, Fresno is always a tough, in fact, I was talking again, Tim and I must have talked for 30 minutes before the game, and you know, Fresno has such a great college atmosphere at their campus, and you know, it is kind of special to play them because they really play a great brand of college football. You know, Pat had his way of doing it. Now that they're playing wide open football, I think he's going to have a lot of success recruiting and getting a lot of talent to come to Fresno.
What were you most pleased with tonight?
I was most pleased that we did what we said we were going to do. We didn't throw the ball to them, except at the very end there. But I thought that we did what we had to do to win the game, and that was, I knew Garrett was going to have to carry the load some running the football. Zach, you know, they were going to be keying on him, so we did a couple of things to that we knew that he might be able to pop open, and he did. And he did what he had to do to win the game for us. Converted a couple of third downs. I don't know what we were, but I would say a couple of them were long yardage situations that he ran to get the first down.
What was Hunt doing that made it tonight so successful?
We had a little bit of a four-man rush. Going, he got his sacks not on dogs and blitzes, but when he was isolated on the tackle or the guard, and the one in the end zone, I think, was a three-man rush. But he's a load, and he's got leverage, and he's learning to play the game, and you know, he's tough to block one-on-one.
And
he's
surprised by the final score, Coach?
Yes, I was. But you know, when you have two defensive scores like that, and you know, I kind of thought when we got the turnovers early and we got the field position a couple times in the first 15 minutes of the game, when we weren't ahead 21 or 24, we were only up by 10, I thought it was going to come back to haunt us, you know. Because when you get those kind of breaks early in the game with field position and turnovers, you got to convert them, and we did not do that.
A lot of times it was matched up against a freshman there. Was that kind of a matchup you guys wanted to take advantage of?
We knew we kind of had Mace had a game plan to isolate him on the that side of the football, both on the tackle and the guard, and two different schemes that we had.
Is it correct that you guys he was on campus and you guys saw him there, and that's how you got him?
Well, what happened was the track coach who has been a very successful track coach at SMU, Dave Woolman. Marcus was a junior world record holder in the throws, and so Estonia was not going to renew his scholarship money to SMU because they're having kind of a downturn in their economy over there, so they were withdrawing. So Dave knew that if he couldn't be put on football scholarship, he wasn't going to be able to stay at SMU. So what happened was, I worked them out. We ran, looked at him, talked with him, and I think you guys know that I've taken chances on guys like him before, and it was not hard for me to see that, you know, world-class athlete that can run like that, has strength like that, arm length, that I could teach him how to play football. The first scrimmage we had, we put him in. The only thing I didn't know was he going to be tough enough, you know, and the first play, we ran a trap at him and hit him real hard, and he wanted to fight. So immediately I said, okay, we may have a player here. You know, he's one of those guys. So that was good.
You
You talked about Garrett putting it on his shoulders today. How much has Timmy helped with his development?
Timmy has been a real blessing. You know, he's grown up. He sees. He understands what we're doing, and he gets. He has a good one-on-one relationship and can talk with the quarterbacks. So that's all positive. Timmy's really matured. He's grown up, and I think he has a bright future as a coach ahead of him.
Coach, you're coaching this bowl game a lot. You think from what you saw from Fresno State's performance, maybe they weren't as focused on your perspective?
Well, I mean, I don't know how to answer that question. I mean, if you were to ask me, I mean, I would be shocked that we would go in at halftime with that kind of lead, you know. But our kids, like you say, have been here. We know we've been focused. We've been to four bowl games. We lost one of them, of the four, to Army when we turned the ball over. And so basically, when you don't turn the ball over, you're going to have an opportunity to win the game. And I don't know what the giveaway takeaway was today, but we're probably plus, I would imagine. And then the safety, you know, is like a turnover also.
I wonder if you can talk about the one drive that that Garrett led after Fresno scored. That seemed like
I think that was the biggest drive that we had, and that said a lot about him. You know, I think after they scored, we threw a pick and they scored. After that, he took us right down the field, made two, well, really three throws that were big throws, and I could tell he, you know, that's his competitive spirit, and he's a real competitor. He won a state championship in high school. And he's a winner. You know. And I think the more he's around the offense, the better he's going to get as we get better around him, too.
You talk a lot about turnovers, which are obvious, but even without him, it just seemed like Derek was pretty much running for his life.
Well, we knew that we thought that we could stop their run game, and we did. And I was concerned because we had not defended quarterbacks that had passed the ball efficiently during the season. We had failed in pass defense. We made some changes, Mason did some things in the back end that were different than what we had shown on film. And I think for a little while, it took him a little while to work it out. In the meantime, the pass rush got to him. And you know, I thought Coach Mason did a great job.
Coach, about 5 years ago in this game, Chris Johnson was kind of introduced to the world from a small school. Not too many people know about him. Do you see a similar thing with Marcus Hunt, and this could be a...
Well, this stage on Monday Night Football, the only game in town, I mean, if you're going to have a game, that's the one to have it in. And I think that, like I said, he's only played 3 years of football. He holds the NCAA record for block kicks. And in the Pitt game last year on national TV, he had a game just like he did today. And I think, I think this stage is big for him, and he's got a chance to be a really good player.
With the Mustang mono shirts and the Warrior helmet stickers, do you feel like that's something these guys really bought into with this bowl game here?
Well, they bought into it for 4 years for us. You know, ever since I got there, we tried to teach them other culture, teach them, you know, different ways of being together, being one, and the spirit, the lowest spirit, the mana, they know what that means. They know that you only earn it in games like this. You get a swagger when you earn it in warfare, and that's where we have done it, and the kids understand and buy into to doing it.
Last question. Any others?
How would it feel to be back here and play against the Hawaii Warriors?
Well, you know, I kind of thought that when I went to SMU, the time had just been bad timing. You know, when we've been good, UH is struggling. When we were not there, you know, UH made the bowl. I mean, I thought that, you know, when we put this together, one of the reasons that if UH is bowl eligible, they play at home is because the crowd will be here. And, you know, that part of it, I knew one day if SMU and UH play here, we'd probably sell the stadium out. That's a good thing. All right, thank you.